energy savings. In this video, we want to take a look at an example where we will analyse the energy usage of an existing system. Many existing systems may be inefficient because the pipe sizes are too small, which leads to higher than optimal fluid velocities. Although using a smaller size pipes may be cheaper initially, in the long term, these inefficiencies could make your design the far more expensive option. Designs with correctly sized pipes will use less energy and save on operating costs year after year. In this example, we want to update the nominal pipe diameters of the steel Schedule 40 pipes with energy savings in mind. For liquid systems, it is often accepted that a fluid velocity of less than 1.5 meters per second should be used where possible, with pipes sized generously on the suction side of pumps to give a fluid velocity of 1 meter per second. A lower fluid velocity will help to minimize pressure losses and reduce the energy used in the pipe system. When we solve this system initially with the pipe diameters set to a nominal 300 millimeters, we see that the velocities are around 2 meters per second. We know that larger velocities in pipes can lead to an increase in pipe friction losses and therefore increase operational costs. We can also see that the energy loss due to the pipe friction is reported in the results sheets here. Looking at pipe 3, for example, the energy loss here is 0.38241 kilowatts. Let's now increase the nominal pipe diameter in the system to see the effect on the energy losses. To update the pipe diameters in the model, we will use a group update. You can watch our quick start guide video to system amendments and group updates for a step-by-step guide on this. As seen previously, we will first update the default pipe diameter and copy this to the selected pipes. So let's increase the diameter to the main line to a nominal 400 millimeters and size the suction side generously to 450 millimeters. Resolving the model, we now see a more reasonable velocity of 1.25 meters per second in the main line and a 0.989 meters per second in the suction side of the pump. Comparing the energy loss in pipe 3, we now see that this has been reduced to 0.129672 kilowatts. Thanks for watching this video on energy savings, and make sure to take a look at our other Pipeflow Expert tutorial videos available on our website at www.pipeflow.com.